The archaeological investigation in North Black Sea region has revealed new features in the historical and cultural development of this area during the 14th and 15th century. This was the area of the interaction of several civilizations and states: Golden Horde, Crimean Khanate, the Moldavian principalities, the great principality of Lithuanian and Rus generals and Venetian colonies and forts, and at last the appearance of Ottoman Empire at the last quarter of the 15th century. The complicated position resulted in the specific of the material culture, which takes the trace of identity and syncretism on the vast area from the Baltic and the Black Sea. From the middle of the 13th century, the Golden Horde civilization organized a system of trade and information with customs and special places for rest using the roads of old Rus time. The important place in the infrastructure of that period take place places the cities, which were on the places of the forts along the rivers, especially the biggest ones, as Dniester and Dnieper, not far from the Black Sea. Golden Horde site stopped its function in 16-17 years of the 14th century, but some of them continue its development in the further periods as simple settlements. The especial important place take the cities, which were the main centers of the international trade. On the west direction, it was Belgrade on the Dniester estuary, which was on the intersection of the trade ways in the direction of the Black Sea through Crimea, Byzantium, and the Tagin in the east side of the region. The archaeological investigation of these cities demonstrated the syncretic culture of the Golden Horde, which combined the best examples of culture of the peoples which put under her power. In the course of the excavation of cultural layers of Belgrade, named as Akerman in 14th century, of the end of the 13th, first part of the 14th century, they were represented material culture close to the other region of Golden Horde, and in the same time with own original traits and imports. The architecture of living buildings take many common traits with the Eastern architecture of Golden Horde cities of Volga region, Mongolia, Middle Asia. In material culture, the important place belonged to the pottery. There was the local center of ceramic production of unglazed and glazed ceramic, which were made in the tradition of the leading ceramic centers of the Crimea, Volga region, Transcaucasia, and Byzantium. Besides the local ones, there were items from different regions from East and West, such as Italy, Genoa, and Spain lustre ceramic. It's a ceramic of local production and import from Byzantium. The various artifacts represented several kinds of craft, metalworking, jewelry, bone cutter, and others. In the lower court, bronze limbs of belt and rings made of bronze, silver, and lead found. It is imported ceramic again from different regions. And this is the bronze matrix from making settle belt. Of the great interest of the is the find of bronze matrix or model for the production of settle belt, especially its decorative elements. The central place in composition takes the relief of D or Duo, which remind the images in the art of Chingizit. By the opinion of Mark Kramarovsky, the production of such kind of things close to the traditions of Georgian art. In this connection, the matrix is the evidence of quickly spreading of such symbol, which appeared in early period of Mongol stage through the vast territory of Golden Horde in the border of West and East civilizations. The collection of coins of this period included the items of the first part of the 14th century, the most of which were minted in the capital of Golden Horde in Saray al-Jadid in tribe of Janibek. It is also things, details for self belt and the adornments and coins. After the end of the power of Golden Horde and the victory of the Lithuanian Principality on the Blue Waters in 1362, the fate of Belgrade connected with the Princess of Lithuania. The city, which named as Key of Lithuania for some years, was in their hands, but very soon it turned out in Moldavian Principality. The first fortification in Belgrade, known from Codex Latinus Parisinus of 1396 year under the name Moncastra, but who constructed the first structure of castle continued to be of discussion. In spite of the Polish suzerainty from 1412, Belgrade in the fact was under the power of Moldavian Prince Alexander of Kind. With the help of the great Lithuanian prince Vytautas, the fortification works were provided. New works for creation of powerful fortress took place in 1440. The biggest construction activity was in the time of the government of the Stefan the Great in the second part of the 15th century. The fortress under the name Citate Albe takes square of 9 hectares, consists of 4 courts. This is Ackermann Fortress. This part of was constructed by in the time of Moldavian Principality. Then after that there was some of course building activity of Ottomans, but this part belonged to Principality, Moldavian Principalities. The citadel, 0.1 hectares, belonged to type of Roman Byzantine fortress, and exterior fortification belonged to the Constantinople type by the opinion of Mariana Schlapak. Material culture of the end of 14th and 15th century takes the common features with the syncretic culture of the North Black Sea region, but takes some influences of Moldavia culture in various fields, such as some of pottery, the special buckles of belts known in Bulgaria, Romania and Moldavia, coins of the Moldavian Principality and other things. This is buckle parts of Moldavian period from Citate Albe. And this is coins of Moldavian Principality. It's my finds, that is way I, of course, can show you all these things because I excavated Belgrad through 11 years. Material culture of the end of the 14th and 15th century takes the common features with the syncretic culture of North Black Sea region, but takes some influences from Moldavia culture. In 1484, Belgrade was conquered by the troops of Bayezid II and became the part of Ottoman Empire. From that time, the Muslims' infrastructure, first of all, mosque and bathhouse, and the Ottoman material culture, such as millet and ethnic wear, changed the image of Ackermann. This is bathhouse. It was excavated by our expedition for some years for some Turkish project and props with Foundation Max von Bertram and with British Institute in Ankara. For some years we excavated this bathroom. Bath house. The next strategic position on the and I want to of course represent some ceramic from excavation, millet and the early Iznik, the end of 15th, the beginning of the 13th century, 16th century. Excuse me. The next strategic position on exit from the Dnieper Bug estuary into Black Sea was Teikochakov, which known in the history under various names, Jan Kerman, Dashov, Ochak, Kale, and others. The Golden Horde periods of this fortress was discovered in the course of our excavation on the place of the fortress and city structure, when under the layer of early Ottoman period, the sgraffita ware of 14th, 15th century found. The same ceramic were in the Dniprovka II, Kutsurup, and other places near Ochakiv. It is all our excavation also. 25 years we were in Ochakiv. The other part of the North Black Sea area was the Lower Dnieper region, where from the old Rus period, the mixed population have been lived. as nomads and as settled population of various ethnic origin. In the Golden Horde times, some settlements continued to exist, then new cities with typical Muslim traits appeared. There were at last four big cities, centers of trade, and those which were in the places of forts take the defense function also. It's by the opinion Yegorov, Vladimir Yegorov, and Mikhail Yelnikov. There are cities situated on the following places: Velikie Kuchuguri, Kinsky Vody, Yurkivka, Tavansky, and Teginsky. The first one situated in Velikie Kuchuguri was a very open city, 10 hectares square, nearby modern Zaporozhye. By opinion of Yegorov, it can be identified with the city Mamaysaray, the important administrative and political center of Mamay Horde. In the course of archaeological excavation, there were discovered 26 buildings, remains of mosque, madrasa palace, bath house, and living houses. It was excavation of Vasily Dovzhenok. The collections of city typical for Golden Horde, but with the numerous prestige items, imports from East and West, such as ceramic of provincial Byzantine types, Khwarezmians, and even Chinese celadons. The investigation of next Tatar city near Yurkivka, provided by Mikhail Yelnikov, discovered the specific of monumental architecture, which take the features of Seljuk style and take analogies in the architecture of mosque of Uzbek, Madrasa of Solkhat, and other monumentals of Crimea. The regional ethnic and cultural specific of the region of the Lower Dnieper represents the materials of some cemeteries, the echelon monuments of which is the cemetery of the end of 13th, the beginning of 15th century, Mamay Surka in Zaporozhye region, by the number of burials, variety of artifacts, ethnical and religious status, such as 30% of burials were of Christians. On the east direction of North Black Sea, the important site was Tyaginka in Kherson region. It was the island, the square of 18 hectares, the island surrounded by river Tyaginka, which fall into river Dnieper. In the course of the first archaeological investigation of Gashkevich in 1914, the fortress constructed by the great Lithuanian princess Vytautas was discovered. Besides of it, the part of cemetery was excavated also. Some irregular studies of Tyaginka were also continued in the 19th and at the beginning of the 21st century. In the course of our excavation in 2016-2018, the ideas of Yegorov and Yelnikov about the existence of Tatar city confirmed on the materials of settlements. This is island Tyaginka, Kherson region, and the places of our excavations. As it was established in the Golden Horde period, it was the city of its syncretic culture, typical for other cities of the North Black Sea area, with a system of water pipes, glazed ceramic, such as graffiti ware, and other signs of culture of that time. The new period of the life connected with the fall inside of Golden Horde and new political situation after the Battle of Blue Water, creation of Grand Duchy of Lithuanian Rus, Žemaitisk, and other lands. The territorial possessions of the Golden Horde was pushed to the mouth of the Dnieper and then to Tavan as the border of Kiev Principality in the structure of the Grand Duchy of Lithuania. With the foundation of the fortress Tagin by Prince Vytautas, it became the border for Golden Horde and important custom house for transitional trade. There was the main way in the direction of Kiev, Lviv, Krakow, and further to Europe. The presence of Lithuanian customs, service, or other official men represented by artifacts of Lithuanian origination. It is settlement Tyaginka, it is a cross-shaped overlay of Lithuanian origin. We find it last years. There were cross-shaped overlays on leather wallets, full analogy of which is in the collection of cemetery Diktara in Lithuania of 14th-16th centuries, and the same forms known among the valleys from cemetery of Karmelavy, 14th-16th centuries in Lithuania. It is important to add that in the cemeteries of Lithuania present some adornments, such as a ring known about the nomads artifacts of Golden Horde period spreading from Baltic to Black Sea. Coins represented by finds of the end of 14th, first part of 15th century, and there are silver and bronze Golden Horde coins, sometimes with coffee counterpart, and Polish coins of Władysław Warnęczyk, 1434-1444, from Krakow. The walls of fortress built from limestones with some wooden construction. The part of wall inside the outer wall on the shaft of the fortress and one of the supporting wall were discovered. And this is the fortress again on the photo of 2018. In the time of excavation of Gashkevich, it was known only one part of this fortress, but this year we find the next part, so now we have the plan of this fortress which we excavate this year. Thanks to the ortho photo and plan and the size nearby 0.5 hectares of the fortress of Vytautas, which extend at least in the late of 14th, first half of 15th century, was obtained. The walls of fortress built from limestones with some wooden constructions. The part of wall inside an outer wall on the shaft of the fortress and one of the supporting wall were discovered. This is a part of the wall, outer wall of Teginka fortress, and this supporting, of course, part. At the wall, many crossbow balls, which have analogies in Lithuanian and other European antiquities, found. The artifacts preserve the features of syncretic culture of Golden Horde, typical for this period in the North Black Sea area. This is a fortress, the part of outer wall, which was discovered this year. This is excavation, view on excavation, the fortress. This you see some parts of the outer walls which were found this year. And this is pottery and glaze, you see, with glaze and ango, which are characters for culture of Golden Horde, one of the part of these ceramics have full analogy in the works of Vladimir Kovan, and we speak about these ceramics. So the existence of Vytautas custom house was not so long, which supported by written court records and 16th century. At the end of the 15th century, political situation was changed and the river Dnieper was on the of the border of Lithuanian Polish state. The custom house inside of territory of Golden Horde possession lost the actual meaning and stopped its existence. In 1491, Crimean Khan Mingligirei founded his own fortress on the Tyagin. The investigation of the cultural heritage of 14th-15th century in the North Black Sea area evident that coexistence of various systems and cultures resulted in the syncretic culture of Golden Horde period. It gave possibility to trace the global tendencies of the development of this complicated period of history of this region. Thank you very much. And this is the place where maybe the ships come, because this year we find during our investigation, chosen underwater investigation, we find this one, where ships come. Thank you very much.
Thank you.